So it's time for you to begin to prepare. Begin to prepare before your opportunity come. The door will be open in a short while from now. That favor you've been looking for will come. That letter you've been waiting for to be signed will soon be signed. Am I talking to anybody here? The email will soon stream into your box. But my question is, when it comes, will you be prepared enough to handle the opportunity? Preparation is critical. If you remember the man called David, most of us are Bible students enough to know about David. David happens to be that man who also prepared for the manifestation of his divine opportunity. You know, the Bible says when Goliath showed up and everybody retreated, including the king, the Bible said when David came to the battlefield, came to the front line, and he saw this man bragging, you know what? Everybody saw him as a giant that was too big to be confronted. David saw him as a giant that was so big that he couldn't miss. You see, perception governs reality. Perception governs what, sir? It governs reality. You know, some see the cup half empty, some see it half full. Perception governs reality. Now, David showed up. I don't want to bore you with the story. You know it all. But where I'm going to is this. When it was time for David to seize the moment, the Bible says, and David pulled out 5 stones from his bag. Thank you, Jesus. He pulled out. I like Mama doing that. Before I even mentioned it, Mama was doing this. She was ready to throw something, you know. God bless you. Now, David pulled out 5 smooth stones, not just stones, smooth stones, 5. He had them in his pouch, waiting for the season when the opportunity will present itself. He was not a man that was getting ready. He was a man that was ever ready. Am I talking to anybody in the house of God here? And so the Bible says, and David, look, you see, David did not sit down to consult which one of the stones should I pull out. Any one of them was equal to the task. You see, he had prepared his stones. I like this. He had prepared his smooth stones. And not only that, he has also proven his sling. You see, David didn't have the time to come to the battlefield and then try to say, okay, let me see if this thing works, you know. No, 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 no. David had proven his slings. He had also proven his stones. They were smooth stones. Everything ready for that divine opportunity. Am I talking to anybody? Please let me touch your neighbor and say to your neighbor, gather your smooth stones. Yeah, gather your smooth stones. Please, I'm not talking about rough stones. I'm not saying that when you're invited for an audition and then you're coming to the place and then you're trying to now read your script. Read your script before the time comes. Am I talking to somebody in the house of God? Put your dots together, cross your T's, and make sure that everything you need for that, that interview, make sure everything is ready. You do not have the opportunity to begin to prepare when your opportunity shows up. Stop trying to learn to become a wife when a brother shows up. How did I get there? Okay, it's men's conference. Okay, all right, let me talk to the brothers. Stop trying to learn how to be a father when a woman has just showed up. You see, learn that before she comes. Prepare your stones before the battles come. I'm speaking to entrepreneurs under the sound of my voice. Begin to prepare. Opportunities are coming into this country. Nigeria is one of the fastest growing economies in the world. I had already said that about two, three years ago. I remember sometimes ago I came to the church and I spoke to you about the fact that, you see, as you travel around the world, one of the things that you find out is that the middle class is shrinking in America, shrinking in Europe. This is one magical country where the middle class is ever expanding. And you see, any nation where you find the middle class increasing, the potential for the increase in their GDP is usually very strong. And that's what's going on in this country. You see, in the oil and gas sector, God is waiting for some of us. I know there are too many bottlenecks. Can I say something to you? The wisdom of the magicians will begin to fail them. Don't worry about all these people who have ganged up together to say that, no, if you don't bow to us, you will never have a chunk of that. You see, the God who put an end to their reign in Egypt, that same God has arisen over this country. Am I prophesying to somebody here? I know some of you have kept your plans, you've kept your proposal, because you say, look, this is difficult to do business here. So let me just keep all of this. Please go back home tonight, dust your proposals. Go back home tonight and begin to, because I'm speaking to you by the Spirit of God. You see, the Bible says he was sitting down, not knowing that Jesus was about to pass by. I came here to let you know that opportunities are about to knock on your doors. Opportunities are about to pass by you. And it's critical that you prepare for the time when those opportunities will show up. Somebody say prepare.